Next question is, the integer next above root 3 plus 1 whole power 2m contains. So this number is nothing but what? It will be integer plus fraction part. So I is what? Integer. And f is belongs to closed interval 0 to open interval 1. So I plus f is nothing but what? Root 3 plus 1 whole power 2m. Similarly, we can say root 3 minus 1 always lie from greater than 0, less than 1. If I take power 2m, so 0 is less than root 3 minus 1 whole power 2m is less than 1. So this one we will assume as f dash. So f dash is nothing but what? Root 3 minus 1 whole power 2m. Now what we will take? I plus f we can write as what? In bracket root 3 plus 1 whole square power m. So if I take whole square, so this will come as 3 plus 1 plus 2 root 3 whole power m. This is I plus f. Again, the 3 plus 1 is 4 plus 2 root 3 whole power m. So from here, if I take 2 comma, so this is 2 power m in bracket 2 plus root 3 whole power m. Similarly, f dash also, if I take root 3 minus 1 whole square power m, so again if I expand it, this will come as what? 4 minus 2 root 3 whole power m. If I take 2 common, so this will come 2 power m in bracket 2 minus root 3 whole power m. Now we will write the expansion of I plus f. So from here, I plus f is nothing but 2 power m in bracket 2 plus root 3 power m. So we can 2 power m is common in bracket 2 plus root 3 power m expansion we will write. So binomial expansion is nothing but mc0 2 power m plus mc1 2 power m minus 1 root 3 plus mc2 2 power m minus 2 root 3 power 2 plus plus mcm minus 1 2 power 1 root 3 power m minus 1 plus mcm 2 power 0 and root 3 power m. Similarly, we will write expansion of f dash. So f dash equals to, here also 2 power m is pretty common. In bracket, because of negative, alternative positive negative will come. So mc0, this will come 2 power m plus mc1 2 power m minus 1 minus root 3 power 1 plus mc2 2 power m minus 2 minus root 3 power 2 plus dot 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 plus mcm minus 1 2 power 1 minus 1 power minus root 3 power m minus 1 plus mcm root minus root 3 power m will come. Now here we can say second term will be non-integer because root 3 power is 1. Similarly, third term, if I say root 3 power 2, so we can say mc2 is integer, 2 power m minus 2 is integer, root 3 power is even, so this is also integer. So we can say first term, third term, fifth term will be integer. In similarly, in f dash also first term, third term and fifth term, odd term will be integer. And we can say in I plus f and f dash, all term will be what? Same. So if I add it, I plus f plus f dash, so 2 power m is common, even term will be getting cancelled and odd term will be nothing but 2 times is repeated. So we can say this is 2 times and we can say this is integer and odd term is always integer. So we can say this is nothing but 2 times integer, some other integer. So we can say I plus f dash is nothing but what? 2 power m plus 1 into I dash. Now we know I plus f is nothing but root 3 plus 1 power 2m. And f dash is a fraction number. So I plus f dash, we can say from right hand side, this is a integer. So in this number, if you add fraction number and it will become a integer, so we can say that integer number is nothing but what? A next integer above root 3 plus 1 power 2m. So I plus f dash is nothing but what? The integer above root 3 plus 1 power 2m is nothing but what I plus f plus f dash, and this is nothing but what 2 power m plus 1 into I dash. I dash is a different integer. So we can say the next integer above root 3 plus 1 will have 2 power m plus 1 as a factor. So A option is correct.